Hello.
Okay, so we're going to start out this session just like how we kind of done the other sessions. And first off, how are you feeling today?
I'm feeling okay.
Feeling okay?
A little better.
A little better? Okay, so you feel like maybe therapy's helping you a little bit more?
Yeah, I think it's helping some.
Okay, that's great. So we're going to start with the agenda. You know, like we are going to talk about certain things. I also want you to add anything. If there's something that you feel is pressing that you'd like to add to the agenda, tell me so that we can work on that, because you've been in therapy now for 2 weeks and you might have something new that you want to work on, and we can add that to our agenda. I see that you brought your homework. Did you do that this week?
Okay. Yes, I did some of it.
Do you find that it's getting a little bit easier to do the homework? Or is it still
something?
Yeah, I think
gets a little easier.
Okay. And then if there is any pressing matter that you want to talk about, we're also going to add that in today. Like I know we said we'd do that, but I want to make sure that you understand that you are allowed to have your input. I want to know how you're feeling. I want to know if you have something that you want to change and work on. And I'm willing to do that with you. Okay. And then we're going to learn, like we did last week where we learned mindfulness. We're going to work on another technique, something that you can hopefully go on and do as homework again, and will help even further your therapy.
Okay.
Okay. So, kind of tell me how this week's been going for you.
Well, I don't know why it started off really bad. I had a really severe panic attack for what seemingly was no reason at all. I was at work fine, and we had one of our meetings that we talk about for what we're going to do the rest of the day, and I went to my area and all of a sudden my heart started racing and I got short of breath and I got chest pains and I have no idea why it happened, and it lasted for probably an hour and a half.
Wow, that's a long time.
And it eventually just kind of went away as suddenly as it started.
Now, did you try any of the techniques when you were having that panic?
Yeah, I tried to do some of the breathing exercises and the grounding stuff, and it didn't really do much.
So why do you think it wasn't helping you at that time?
I have no idea.
Were your thoughts just so far gone that kind of trying to center yourself was just not there?
Yes.
That's something I wanted you to continue to work on. And maybe even, like I know you said in your, what I heard you say was that you don't even know what happened to bring on that panic attack.
Pretty much.
Okay. And sometimes, in some cases, we not always know. But if some, you can maybe try to think about it and do a thought record, write down, you know, this is kind of what I noticed. Maybe something was said in the meeting that maybe kind of triggered your panic attack and you didn't even notice, or maybe something even earlier in the morning happened and it kind of just built up and then you had the panic attack. So if you could try maybe treading that way, if you can notice the beginning signs, you won't get to the full-blown panic attack. You understand why I want you to kind of start to write down?
Yeah.
Is that something you think you could do?
I can try.
Okay. I also like to notice today that you seem a lot more uplifted. Even though your week started out bad, did it get better after that?
Yeah, my week got a little better after that. Because, of course, my boss kind of noticed what was going on and noticed that I just seemed off. And so he kind of checked on me and I said I was fine. And then after, you know, later on in the day, after everything, at the end of the day, he asked me to come over to his office, and I went into his office and he asked what really happened, and so I kind of told him what happened, and he said that next time anything like that happens or I feel off or anything, he wants me to be okay with telling him that, because he said that the policy that a lot of people don't really realize is that they want people to be able to put in their best effort and do their best at their job, and if there's something that's preventing them from doing that, then they need to, you know, for whatever, however long it is, take them and have them do something else or something. So that was kind of good to hear.
Yeah, that must be nice to feel supported by your boss.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, And you know what? Someone else probably is having some sort of panic attacks, and it's nice to know that they're there to support you and that you can say something, that you're not, there's nothing wrong with you for having panic attacks. So that's really great. How does that make you feel, knowing that your boss is there to support you?
Well, I mean, it helps. It certainly makes me feel a little more relaxed, just because, I mean, a lot of the reason that I don't bring any of this up, certainly at work, is because I worry that I'll get fired or sent home, or, you know, hey, we'll find somebody that can do the job. If you can't do it, get out of here.
Yeah. That's great. Well, I'm glad that you have the support that you need at work. That way that maybe that can alleviate some of the stress. Because in our first session, we were talking about how you were worried that if you didn't get this under control, you might lose your job. So
yeah,
now
so it sounds like that's not necessarily the case, at least as long as we can figure out how to keep it under control.
Okay. Mm-hmm. We're going to talk about something a little bit later, and I want to come back to that statement about how your thoughts created the rest of your reactions, okay? So, how did you do with your homework this week?
I did okay. I started to do more of the journaling and stuff like we had talked about. It got a little easier, but, you know, I'm still, it's still difficult to put right down what some of the things I think about, just because it sounds so negative when I write sometimes.
And that's why we're here, because we're in CBT, we're trying to change your negative thoughts. So maybe something that you could add to this week when you're journaling is, if you see yourself writing a negative thought, let's change it to something a little bit positive. So if it's you're writing down like, what's something that maybe was going through your head when you were writing down some negative things?
The night that I had the panic attack, I was just writing that, you know, I can't control this. Why am I like this? You know, what's going on? Mm-hmm. Am I having a heart attack? Just completely freaking out and just not knowing anything. So it's just kind of random thoughts and statements.
So it is okay. That's the one thing I want you to understand, that you are normal and that it is something, you are working on it. So even though you're saying, why isn't this working, you're making steps towards getting it under control. And there are some days that it might not go as great as others. But as long as you learn the skills, what you're working on, you can get it to a point where you'll be able to maybe notice the beginning signs and work through them a little better. Okay, I'm glad you did your homework. What about the mindfulness techniques, the deep breathing and things like that? Kind of noticing, like centering yourself.
I tried doing those a little bit more. They seem to help a little bit. Hard to say now.
Is it just something you find like it's harder to do?
Yeah, it's just hard to get into the, you know, when I have issues or whatnot, it's not something that's second nature yet to think about doing. So I kind of automatically revert to the freak out mode.
Okay. Is there maybe a way that you could, since you said you had your panic attack at the desk, is there a way to maybe hang a picture of a favorite place for you?
Instead
of doing mindfulness, you could do like a visualization technique where you kind of put yourself in that mode. And that way it's more, okay, something you might think about doing. It's more like that way you see it and nobody else has to know what it's for, right? They can just see it as a beautiful picture and you could sit it somewhere where, okay, I'm back from my meeting. I'm going to take 5 minutes to use some visualization, feel the sun on my skin, or depending on whatever your image is, taking the time to really use all 5 senses to create in your mind.
Okay.
Okay? All right. So is there anything that you would like to add to the agenda?
So at the end of the week, I kind of, again, got into a fight with the wife, argument about what was going on. And then I ended up just showing her the journal that I wrote from the day of my panic attack. Mm-hmm. And it seemed to go a little better at least, because she, her reaction was kind of like, oh, I didn't really realize it was this bad, really, was when she was reading through it. And she just kind of, she got kind of quiet and silent, and then she kind of stopped, acted kind of confused. So I'm still not really sure how to bridge that gap.
Okay. But at least it's, I'm glad that you showed her the journal. I'm glad that, because sometimes we have significant others in our life that don't know what's going on. And we hold it in, and then all of a sudden something bad happens, and then our family's going, I didn't know there was anything going on, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so have you opened up that line of communication with her with the journal?
Kind of.
Okay, so something you still want to work on is opening that communication with her?
Yeah.
Okay. Is it best for you to write your feelings down and have her read them, or?
It's probably a lot easier for me to do that, yeah.
Okay. Do you think that's something you're willing to work on? I know I'm throwing a lot at you this week. We'll kind of narrow it down to one thing.
I can try, yeah.
Okay. But
at least try to do it once.
Okay, so since we have thrown so much at you, what I'm hearing from you is that maybe you kind of got the journaling down, you can do the mindfulness, you can do some visualization techniques, but you really would prefer to work on learning how to communicate with your wife. Okay, so let's do that then. Let's work on if communication with her, if you find that it's easier to write down and have her read it, that's what I want you doing for your homework. And it's even something like, if you want to write it down and it's something that you and I can go over with, we can do that next week. But my one key advice would be, make sure you put I statements in there. Like, I feel this when this happens. Because if you write something to your wife, you never want to attack. Because then she's going to shut down, and then what you needed to get said isn't going to be said. Do you understand that? What I mean by I statements?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. All right. So, there's going to be another thing I've noticed today is when you said that you wanted to talk to your boss, but you were afraid that if you talked to him and told him what was going on, that you felt like you would be fired. So part of CBT is, the CBT model is, and I'm going to give you a little paper on it. It is how a situation creates thoughts, and then that creates an emotion, and then that creates a behavior. So correct me if I'm wrong, but your thought was, because I have panic attacks, I'm not good at my job. So then your thought became, I'm going to get fired. Your emotion was probably, what was your emotion, would you say?
Fear.
Fear.
Anger.
Okay. And then what would was your behavior?
Probably withdrawn.
Okay. So then I kind of, so nobody knew at work what was going on, because you just couldn't, you were just like, trying to get your job done, but you have all these things going on in your head, right? Okay, so this week I want you to start kind of thinking about what you're thinking about. Like what situations are happening, what response you're getting out of it, what emotion it brings up, and then what behavior comes with it. Because instead of saying, oh, I have panic attacks, I'm a failure, I'm going to get fired, I want your situation to be like, I have panic attacks, I have some skills that I can work on, that will then uplift your mood, and then your behavior will be, I can do this. I can continue to be a good employee and still have panic attacks. Do you understand how that works?
I think so.
Okay.
It's kind of like a mindfulness type of thing.
Kind of a mindfulness thing, but it's also changing those negative thoughts, because if we're thinking negatively about ourselves, we're not going to have behaviors that are positive towards us, towards our own self, right? Okay. So that's what your, I'd like your homework to kind of be. And I know that, and I'm also thinking that we can integrate this in with your wife. So because she comes home and she's mad at you, do you then kind of maybe think, oh, I'm a failure. I'm a failure as a husband.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then you kind of, what does that make you think? So the situation is your wife comes home, she's like, oh, why haven't you done this? Then you think of yourself, oh, I'm a failure. And then what kind of that, how does that make you feel?
Kind of kind of makes me angry because I do help out a lot.
Right. And then what kind of, then your end result of your behavior that you actually do? Do you find
probably withdrawn again.
Withdrawn again? Okay. So, I think that's something that you could write down and, you know, in your journal, some things, some situations that happen. When this happened, I did this because of this with your wife. And that way you can kind of show her, like, these are the things that are going on. I would rather you come and talk to me and say, hey, can you help me with this? Or if you're busy right now, right? So some things, is there ways that you would like her to talk to you? What are some ways that you would like her to help you?
Just be a little less confrontational,
mm-hmm.
I guess.
That's a hard thing, because you're two people, two very different people, having your own things go on. And sometimes in a marriage, when there's children and other things involved, you kind of forget that the other person has their stuff going on too, right? Okay. So do you think you could work on maybe like a thought record?
Yeah, I can do that.
Okay, maybe show your wife that, and so you guys can work on it together. I still think that maybe if this is something that still needs more work, bringing her in and having her kind of understand what CBT is and how she can help you. Okay?
Okay.
Is there anything else that you would like to add to today?
No, I think I'm good.
Okay. The last thing is we've been doing this now for 2 weeks in session, and then today makes it 3 weeks. Do you have any feedback for me?
The first time I've been in therapy, I don't really know mm-hmm. how it's supposed to go. So,
okay. But how have you seen improvements in yourself?
Yeah, I think it's helped some.
Okay. That's very good. All right, and then anything else you want to talk about? Maybe something you just need to get off your chest or add?
No, I'm good.
Okay. I'm glad to see that you are more uplifted in talking today. You kind of opened up. I'm very happy that your boss was able to communicate with you and let you know that you're supported there. So that's great. And I hope you keep coming back to therapy, and I will see you next week. Okay.
Next week.
And bring your homework with you, okay?
Okay.
All right. Sounds good. Bye.